Hello everyone, I'm Rajesh from Asian Technology. We are learning complete Bootstrap course from beginners to advanced level. And now we are going to learn Bootstrap 4, not a Bootstrap 3. So let's start it. So you see, last class we already downloaded our Bootstrap files right here. So I'm going to use this Bootstrap file in my bracket. So please, if you don't know how to download this bracket, please contact me. If you know this one, is fine. Let me tell you something how to download this one. So just quick view, just click here, Google, very easy, just write bracket.io. If you're using window, no need to write io, just write bracket and see the first one, just click here and just download from here. And install this software is very easy. So here I'm going to quick start here. So you see our bracket is here, right? So I'm going to include my file, this all my files in my bracket. So this is very easy. Just search, click here and open new folder. And you see in our desktop, right? This folder on our desktop, so I'm going to click here and see here and this select. So now you see my Bootstrap file now is here, right? And inside C, you can see C files here and the JS files here, right? So we are going to use this C, means Bootstrap files, and the this JS file in our web page. So this is very easy. Let me start quickly. Just make big. So I want to create a new project here. So if you want to create a new project, you can click here and also click here. You can create a new project. But I'm not going to create from here. I'm going to click here, right click, and the new file here. Then my file name is my project and .html. Please don't forget write .html. Okay. Here you can see here now. So now I'm going to write our Bootstrap code here. So let me tell you first, any kind of HTML tag, this means starting and this means closing. If you see double code, that means close, and if you don't see double code, if you see the slash, that means closing. If you don't see slash, that means it's not closing, it's starting. Okay, so let me teach you a little bit about HTML and the Bootstrap. So here, if you want to write HTML, please write HTML here, because we are going to start our project in HTML, right? So you have to start using HTML from HTML. And see, when you see why I am using Bootstrap, is very quick. Just write HTML, and when I'm going to press this button, just you see automatically going to close, right? So you no need to write again this close tag, is very easy. So you see here HTML start from here and close here, right? So inside HTML we are going to write all codes inside HTML here. So after HTML, always you have to start our head like a same person, right? First part is head, then second part is body, right? So first part head. So inside head you have too many brains, right? Brain and what eye, mouth, what. So this part is very important, right? So head part is very important in your web page. So inside your head part, please first choose your CSS, and here have too many files, right? Let me tell you one, just one, anyone. Oh, first one we need to use, this one is very important for our page. So I'm going to include this page here. So let me show you how many code are here. Just double click here. You see, it's too many codes, right? So this code we are going to use here without writing this code. So just click in here, and here I'm going to use this file. So if you want to use this file, first you see the file and last part here, right? .css or .js. So you, of course, is inside CSS folder. That means this is CSS, right? So anytime if you want to link CSS, please here write link. If you want to link anytime, if you want to link CSS, please write link. And inside the link, first you have to write rel. Rel means rel, means the, and here and double quote, right? And this is a double quote. We have to write style sheet. Style sheet means this is inside CSS, and these 5 pages are styling our web page. So we have to write link rel style sheet. That means style sheet, right? But which one we are going to write, because here too many, right? So which one we are going to use? So I am going to use this one, right? So I have to include this folder here. So anytime if you want to include a folder, you have to write href and the okay, and the href again double quote, please don't forget double quote. And inside double quote, first you have to write this folder name. The folder name is what? CSS. And the CSS folder, inside folder, right? So if you want to go inside folder, write slash. Don't forget slash, okay? And the, that means I am inside CSS. So inside CSS, you see too many folder files here, right? So which one are you going to write? Here, bootstrap.min.css, so write this name here. Even if I, if you want to write here, then you can write. If you want to choose from here, you can choose from here. You see, is here, right? So I'm going to just click here. That means I included this file is here. So after CSS file, I'm going to include my JS file. So JS file is really very important. And inside JS file also I have too many files, you see here. But I'm not going to use all files. I'm just going to use only one, bootstrap.min.js, same like this, right? So just enter here. It's also very easy. If you want to link a JS file, .js file, so please you write a script. And inside the script here, you have to write very easily src. Src means source code. And inside source code, our file is inside JS, right? So choose JS. And inside JS, you see too many files, right? But we are going to use only one. Which one? Bootstrap.min. So find here is the last one. Done, right? Only this. You see, link start but not close. But Java's this script is start, but you see it's closed, right? So only two files I am going to include from these two, and we will later we'll include more files. So it's done. And after complete this including files, you have to write your web page title name. What you're going to show in your web page. Let me show you one. For example, anyone, which one? Let me show you one page. This one, right? So just wait. My network is very slow. You see here the top one, see the top, this one is the Go Dream, right? So this one is the title. So what you want to show in your top, you have to write here inside title. So after head and after linking and inside, you have to write title, right? Is correct? There have any problem, just write title. So don't forget title always inside head. Why? The reason is you see title always on top, right? Top means inside head. So here, so inside title here you don't need to write any things here. And the between starting and the ending, you have to write your title name here. So I'm going to write first bootstrap for project. Control yes, done, right? So only head part you have to have only these things. First is link bootstrap.min, and the second is link bootstrap.js, and then after that third is title. So that's all and done. And the but the most popular programmers always use here on top this sign and write doc means document, tpy type means document type, which kind of HTML. If you don't write this code is also fine, but if you write this code is very good. So I'm going to write this code. So after head you have to start body part. Just remember, a human person after head is body part, right? So I'm going to write in body part my all code. So body part and HTML always together, because we are going to write our code here. We are not going to write after body, so we are going to write our all codes here. So it's very easy. First I'm going to print my heading. So for heading you can able to use h1, h2, h3, h6. You see here, so h1 means very big, second means smaller than h2, h3, h4. Let me show you one by one. See here, just I'm writing h1 and control s, and you can see go in browser and try to find your file here, and you see here is our software, right? Just click here and you see it big here, but I need more small. So if you need more small, so just here you have to write h2. h2 is smaller than h1. So same things, heading, control s, again I'm going to browse my page, refresh. You see this one is big, this one is small, right? And let me teach you again. Here if you write h3 and if you write anything blah blah blah, control s and the refresh here, more is small. So that means h1 is bigger one and the smaller is smaller, right? Until h6. So this is our heading, but this is not our Bootstrap text. This is just a simple HTML. For example, let me show you one tag, like just let me create one button in Bootstrap. Button, and inside button you have to write class. Class is boolean warning. Please don't need to worry about this. I will learn write how to write button. I'm going to show you why we need to use Bootstrap. So this is button. I'm just trying to submit, control s, and you can see here it's very nice effect. If this is not a nice effect, there have some problem. I think I forget something here. Forget what? Boolean warning. I forget yen. So you again see here, you see the color, right? So if you want to, if you don't include this Bootstrap files, just delete Bootstrap file, then let me show you. This is a simple button, right? Can you see? Simple button, right? But if you include this one, and you can see, that means we are using Bootstrap. You see, nice effect, right? Not only this is button, when we write our big project, when you complete our project, then you see is very nice effect when you use Bootstrap. So this is our Bootstrap, right? So let me configure our Bootstrap. So I think next video we're going to configure for today is enough. I told you some things, small things, how to start HTML, how to this one, how to simple S1, right? And next video we are going to write more links here, and we are going to write from starting from professional, like a professional. So let me see you in next video. Stay tuned. Goodbye.